It's mid-afternoon in downtown Toronto, and the streets are cluttered with a mass of humanity. Everything seems fine on the surface, but unbeknownst to these passerbys, one of the most feared creatures in the animal kingdom lurks in the shadows. Today we explore the sportscaster outside of its natural habitat. You see, in his natural habitat of working for a major sportscasting network, the employed sportscaster is content as he has access to footage, to events, and to professional athletes themselves. Remove him from his natural habitat, however, and... well... Hi there, folks! We're here to interview Blue Jay slugger Jose Bautista. Follow me!
Whoa, what are you doing?
What?
There's no entrance to the stadium right now.
I have an interview with Jose Bautista. It's okay.
The team's in Baltimore.
Nope, I don't think that that's correct. Hey, Greg. Yeah, it's Marc Richler. Yeah, Mark with a B. Jose! It's me, Jose! Jose! Jose?
Eventually, the unemployed sportscaster will become desperate for material. And once its raw animalistic instincts take over, well, we're all at risk.
This is skateboarding at its finest. They're all looking at me. This is riveting stuff. We're here with Francisco Cordero. What's the deal? Why are we having so much trouble?
I don't know.
Highly professional answer. I have no idea.
It'll come around.
Will it?
It will.
I don't believe him. Was that your goal, just pepper the goalie all game?
It was. I peppered him hard.
That's not what she said. And he is skateboarding. He is putting his pants down and pulling his shirt up over his head, off of his body. Pants are...
is that kind of
back on his body.
Marc Richler is the next big guy at the score.
Is that correct? I can't hear you. The downward spiral continues as the tolls of sportscast deprivation entrench their way into the fabric of the unemployed sportscaster's personal life. Of course they're gonna win eventually, but until they do, you shouldn't be calling yourself King James, that's all I'm saying. You're right. I'm sorry. In its natural habitat, meeting interesting new women is no problem for the employed sportscaster. Hey. No problem. But for the unemployed sportscaster.
Enjoy.
Thanks so much, babe. Dennis Quaid walks into the Starbucks, but nobody knows that Ellen's in his ear like the whole time.
More impressive streetcar up to Brett Favre's consecutive game streak. Keep in mind that Favre had to play every week with 1,000 pounds of defensive linemen trying to injure him, but Ripken had to play every day and couldn't catch so much as the flu. Bullet point answers, go!
And so, deprived of his passion and alienated by society, the unemployed sportscaster falls deep into the depths of depression. If only there were some opportunity out there in the universe.
I'm having a vision. It's me. On the score. Could it be? Could it really be?
It could be, Mark.
Dear God, how? Tell me how.
The answer lies in Gillette drafted 4 on the score. Apply, Mark.
I will, God. I will. Thanks, buddy.
I will apply. And I will work for the score, because this is what God wants for me.
Well, actually, to be honest, dentistry is yours.
Not now. Score? This is what God wants for us.
Okay, well now you're just flat out putting words in my mouth.
Don't do this for me, or for you. Let's do this for God. What do you think about the God line? But seriously, score, if you give me a chance, I promise I won't let you down. This is what I am built for. This is what I'm meant to be doing. If you give me this shot, I will redefine your understanding of hard work. So please, give me a chance. Draft me.
Cause I'm just a kid with a dream and a dream's to be seen. Casting them sports on your TV screen. That could last my dreams, if you know what I mean. Richler's my name, sports light my flame. I'm not here for the fame, I'm here for the game. To proclaim that our aim should be me in the frame. Scoring me, let's be one and the same. Serious later we'll exclaim, but the day we became the greatest tag team duo since the waiting King James. Only thing but our reign, we'll earn our acclaim. Creativity, originality, and that's laced with my superfly hilarity. You don't need Cabby on channel 53 when you got an up-and-coming germer like me. I'll work my face off and face off the tip-off to kick off. Ain't no chance I'm gonna start out strong and then just bounce off. But I digress, I must profess. Don't stress for success with me in the press. So what's left to discuss? And one another, let's trust we must. Score plus me, ain't no stopping us.
And there's no stopping us right now.
There's no stopping us right now.